Welcome back to CHE 205. Today I'll be talking about how we can solve for the root of a function using GoalSeek in Spreadsheet. So Excel has its own built-in function called GoalSeek, where you can use actually the function to solve for the root of almost any nonlinear or linear function for the root. So I'll show you in a minute how we can use this option to solve for the root of the function. In this case, we're not going to look at Vandenberg segregation of state. We're going to look at this nonlinear equation where f of x is x minus x to the 1/3 power minus 2. Okay, so what I'm showing you is in Mac PC. In Windows PC might be a little bit different, but I think the options should be there. And if you've got a problem, then let me know, and hopefully I can post to you another video in Windows version. All right, so this is how we can do it. First we're going to plot the function to find a guess value, because in a spreadsheet you need to have some sort of guess to begin with. So now I'm going to create two columns, x, and here's f of x. This is as usual. And because I don't know how the function is going to look like, let's pick some number. I'm going to, let's say, start with, zero. How about that? All right, now I'm going to implement the equation on the right cell in the f of x column. So the equation is going to be x. So here's x minus x raised to the 1/3 power minus 2. So there's no constant, I'm not freezing anything. All right, so now the next value, let's say I'm gonna try 1. And to populate the equation to this cell, I'm gonna highlight this, drag it down. All right, maybe you would see, oh, there's the same, didn't change, right? Maybe because of the number of digits. So let me increase the number of digits. Yeah, looks like it didn't change, but I think because that's right. I mean, put 0 here, and 1 here, you get minus 2. So let's try another number. I'm going to highlight these two and scroll down one more, and then click on this guy and scroll down. Yeah, it's changing and it's going down in absolute value. It's going up in magnitude, so that means it's in the right direction. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight all three and then scroll down a couple more steps, and you see that, yeah, it's going from minus 2 to 2, so that means it has to hit 0 somewhere between 3 and 4. I don't even need to plot it. I can easily say this by just looking at these two columns, but if you can't figure it out and it's not clear to you, I highly recommend just highlight these two columns and plot it. So I'm going to go to Insert Chart, and then Scatter, Smooth, and this is it. There you go. If you can see it, I can increase the font to 18, which I love. And then here's 18 again. All right, so this is x, this is y. It hits the x-axis between, let's say, 3 and 4 right here. All right, so I'm going to pick maybe a guess of 3. So let's put 3 here. So here I'm solving the same equation using GoalSeek. So I create two rows, like one x and the other one is f of x. These are just text, doesn't mean anything. You can have anything in here, right? So I can have, like, you know, like, ha ha ha. It doesn't matter because Excel doesn't look at this cell. And then this thing is going to be f of ha ha ha, right? So let me expand this a little bit. I just changed this to show you that it doesn't depend on what you have in this cell. This cell is irrelevant. This is just for us, all right? So here is x, this is my guess. Now here I'm gonna implement the equation, which you can see here. Let me click on that. So that is B3, is this cell. Let's say this is my x. So this is going to be this cell minus the same cell raised to the 1/3 power minus 2. It's the same equation implemented with reference to this cell. Okay, all right. So if I put 3, I get this guy. All right, fine. Yes, that's the same thing I got in the plot. But then this is not the root. I want to make this guy 0, right? You have to find ha 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 or x such that f of x becomes 0. So here is the trick. You click on this cell that you want to make zero, right? Then you go to data, or maybe this data, doesn't matter. I'm gonna go to this. If you go to this data, yeah, I think you have to go to the ribbon. So this is the data in the ribbon. And then what if? And then go seek. Right, click on that. It says set cell. So which cell we want to set? Well, this is the cell we want to set, right? It's B4. So the address is fine. To what value we want to set this? To zero. So type zero here. And then by changing what cell? Well, by changing the cell above. So I'm going to click on this, then go back and click on this. So it says now set cell B4, which is this cell, to value zero. Yeah, that is what I'm trying to do by changing the cell above, which is my x. I'm going to change my x such that f of x becomes zero, right? Don't worry about the dollar signs and everything. I think that is fine. Excel takes care of that. And then click OK. And then suddenly you see that it tells you that the goal seek with cell B4, which is this cell, is done and found a solution. The target value is zero. Yes, this is almost zero. Well, you may say, hey, this is 5, 10 to the minus e, 10 to the minus 6. It's not zero. Well, in Excel, we can think of this as almost zero. Excel can't do better than that. I think this is still fine. And that's the root. So I started at 3. And then now you see that it has changed to 3.521, and that's exactly the root. Perfect. So you hit OK and you'll be done. This is the root. No, this is the root. This is f of x at the root, which is almost zero. Sometimes the initial yes leads to a diverging case. So actually, this is a converging case. Let me change this. This should be converging. All right. Let me tell you another example which actually leads to divergence. So that means the goal seek depends on the initial guess. So I'm going to start with zero, right? So zero is right here, and the root is right here. It's a bit far, and for such a case, it actually doesn't get to the root. You see that? Okay, I'm going to set zero here. Then you have to implement the equation here. The equation is exactly as before. I'm going to click on that. Now it's everything with reference to this cell. So I'm referencing this cell, right? So B7, which is this. Minus B7 is the same thing. Raised to the 1/3 power minus 2. All right. Hit enter. So here's the equation. Yes, it's at 0 is minus 2. That's what I got here. But now I'm going to try goal seek to tune this such that I get 0 here. Let's try. So I go to data. One more time. What if goal seek? I'm going to set cell B8. Yes, this is right. I'm going to set this cell to zero, type zero here by changing which cell, the cell above. So I'm going to click on this and go back to the spreadsheet and click on the cell I want to change, which is the X, B7. I'm going to click on that. And this is B7. Now hit OK. So it tried a bit, but it said goal seeking with cell B8. Yeah, we want to make this guy zero. May not have found a solution. You see that? And it's not zero. It's 10 to the plus 14. It's a huge number. It didn't converge. So how come it converged in this case, but didn't converge in that case? It's the same equation, but two different initial guesses. Yeah, so that's the problem with goal seek. The guess should be close enough. This is too far. If it's too far, it can't reach there. Right? Okay. So hopefully this showed you how you can use goal seek. Make sure your guess should be close. And to make a close guess, the best way is to plot the function. Thanks for watching and stay tuned.